Retro Mondays. Hey, what's happening, gamers? Welcome back to another Retro Monday. Finally back on a Monday, no less. Anyway, the aim of the show is always to turn your Monday into a fun day. Today's classic game has a fond place in my heart. What happens when you combine the hit arcade game style of NBA Jam with the zany Looney Tunes action? You get Looney Tunes B-Ball that released in 1995 for the Super Nintendo. The game was actually developed by Sculptured Software and produced by Sunsoft and Warner Bros. Interactive. In case you're all wondering, this game released before Space Jam starring Michael Jordan. Much like NBA Jam, B-Ball is an arcade sports game too. The story for this game involves Bugs and Daffy having wrapped filming for the day, and the two decide to play some B-Ball in the WB parking lot. And that does it for the story. If anyone wants to know what life was like in the early 90s, kids wore bright green shirts and pink hats backwards. So basically it was like the fashion from the 1980s, but minus the parachute pants. Oh, and everything was street style, homeboy. Yeah, I didn't think I could get away with that. Anyway, getting back to the game. B-Ball features both a single and multiplayer options, even two-on-two gameplay where up to four people can play simultaneously with the SNES multi-tap. Looney Tunes Basketball consists of a few modes of interest, like playing against the CPU, or a friend, or entering a tournament where the computer is relentless and evil, but we'll talk about that later. Gameplay is pretty unique. While the game is definitely a clone of NBA Jam, it's actually a good clone of it, right down to the turbo boost, fun dunking mechanics, and he's on fire! However, this game does bring original components to the table as well. Scattered on the courts are various colored gems. As you collect these, you unlock either defensive or offensive abilities. The most amount of gems you can carry is 99 cents worth. The gems will unlock abilities called Acme Plays, and examples of these are long-range shots for three-pointers, making an eclipse to confuse the other team, using a force field to defend yourself, turning the ball into a ticking time bomb or cream pie, and many other zany things. The game also features in-game cheats, which can be used anytime in the game, and they are activated by specific button presses, like most 90s codes. Players can actually customize how long they want the game to go, but its default is set to 2 minutes per round, and there are 4 rounds in all. B-Ball also features a wacky meter that will cause a lot of crazy things to happen in the game. Keep in mind that the less wacky the meter, the less gems that will appear on the court. Controls for this game were pretty easy to pick up and play. The Y button would pass the ball, the B button would shoot, and the top buttons were used to increase your speed. Using special abilities was a snap, and all you had to do was press the A button. Tapping the X button is how you would choose your skill of attack. While on defense, you could smack your opponent around with the Y button or jump in the way of the ball. Just be careful not to get goaltending. Besides that rule, I think the only other rule that applies in this game is losing the ball if you don't shoot within the time limit. Onto the things that I didn't like about this game, and keep in mind these are minor complaints. Has anyone else noticed that all the courts in this game look exactly the same? Even down to the backgrounds and everything else. Would it have killed the developers to change the background or even the time of day to make some type of distinction between the courts? I mean, seriously! I never really noticed this as a kid playing this until the tournament mode. Speaking of tournament mode, it is terrible. The set difficulty is 5 and you can't change it, and while I can defeat a few teams with that difficulty, the AI is wicked cheap in this mode and brutal. It doesn't matter if you pick the fastest characters for this mode either, because somehow the computer will be even faster than you. A good example of this is FUD is now faster than Marvin the Martian. Yeah, like that's possible. Playing this game in tournament mode by yourself is not worth the frustration, trust me, because the computer is twisted. But this is the only time in the game where it feels like any part of it is broken, and that's all I had wrong with this game. Ah, Looney Tunes Basketball really takes me back. How I ended up playing this game is because of two factors, Mr. Pete's and of course the game's box art, which was very important back in the day. If the game looked appealing, the only way you could find out if the game was any good is by looking at the pictures. which isn't the same today because we have, of course, online stuff, reviewers, and lots of ways for you to discern if the game's good or not. Anyway, Mr. Pete described the game to me and my pals and how fun it was to play, so I just had to rent it, and it was only a dollar, so there you go. As soon as I put this game in my SNES when I got home, it became one of my most rented games from Mr. Pete's while I lived in upstate New York. Even my dad got in on the action and loved playing this game with me. His favorite character was Bugs Bunny, and I would always play as Marvin the Martian. While I want to keep strolling down memory lane, it's time to look at the bells and whistles for this game. While I still say the courts are identical, the visuals for this game were really cool for its day. I especially like the character sprites and how expressive the characters were. But not just the characters, the actual profile pictures would respond to things, which was pretty awesome. Everything in this game looked like a cartoon, and I think that was pretty rad. Music for this game was very 90s, it had that hip-hop street vibe to the music, and I feel that it fit this game very well. B-Ball's composition was made possible by these individuals. You all may recall from my Super Star Wars trilogy review that Paul Webb was the guy behind the awesome arrangements. Sound effects for this game were really well done, and after all these years, I can still remember Daffy and Marvin's one-liners like it was yesterday. Still, what made this game so great has to be the gameplay, hands down. I loved playing this game with friends and family. It was an absolute blast. Dunking was a tremendous amount of fun and so much easier than NBA Jam, and the dunks were more exaggerated too, which I love. The gem collecting is what made this game stand out though, and it really played to the Looney Tunes' strengths. Once you get the Acme plays down and figure out which character stats suit your playing style, then you're in for a grand old time playing this game. Out of all the characters in this game, Marvin the Martian was my favorite because he has the best abilities in the game. Well, at least in my humble opinion he does. His long range shot for 3 points was amazing. I really love his vaporizing defense move, and most importantly, Marvin is wicked fast. Actually, if memory serves correctly, he is the fastest character in this game. So, I know what you're all thinking. This game looks really fun, but does it have lasting appeal? Well, the answer to this question is yes. Yes, it does. When playing this game, I would strongly recommend not playing the CPU past level 4, though, as the AI becomes really unfair and just no fun to play against. Although I would say that what made this game just as much fun as I remember is playing it with a friend, in this case, playing it with Amber. Originally, I thought tracking down a copy of this game would be difficult for all of you, because truthfully, I haven't seen this game used in either a game or pawn shop for years. But luckily, Amazon has the game used for $7, so there you go, and I have to say that's a great price for a really fun, zany game. With that being said, I'm gonna recommend this game. Whether you're a fan of NBA Jam or the Looney Tunes games in general, I guarantee you will love this game all the same. Alrighty, that does it for another Retro Mondays. I'm still waiting to hear back from Brooke for the Aladdin co-op video, so until that happens, I have one more solo episode up my sleeve, and it's Kung Fu, the classic NES game. Actually, I think this is one of those games that still haunts me to this day because I can't beat it because the game is really evil. So I hope you look forward to that next week. Just a quick reminder, I do have a Facebook, Twitter, and album on iTunes if you want to check those out. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch another Retro Mondays, and until we meet again, gamers, God bless, and happy gaming.